hey.
Probably not be there.
She will not. She, well.
Wait. When's the last time you saw the elusive?
In between 2 and 3 years ago. So that gap of time has allowed me to reflect upon myself and realize that I may never see her again, just due to the fact that she lives in SF.
I know the feeling.
She lives in SF, and she has her own career and life ahead of her.
She shows up at random times in random places, and you never know when she will show up.
Yeah.
And there's no way to control it. It's like rain. Like, you can do a rain dance to try to make it rain, but it may or may not rain, regardless of what you do.
That's true.
Wow. So is out of the picture.
I'm afraid so. I would not be surprised if I ran into her one day.
Let us hope.
And by that day, I mean like tomorrow. I would not be surprised if I ran into her tomorrow and she was married and had a seven-month-old baby.
If that was the case, I guarantee you she would have bangs.
Wait, hold on.
That's a good message.
And I will not send that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. I was just about to reach out to the send button. I know this is digging deep into the archives, but whatever happened with...
Wow. Digging deep
into the Jedi archives.
You are going deep into the memories.
Hold up. Let me just... guess before you tell me. Let me guess. You never emailed her. You never had any contact with her ever again since then.
You are incorrect. You simpleton. We sat on the porch of the ski lodge, and we just talked. And then we exchanged numbers. We talked, I would say maybe 2 or 3 times. But, you know, long-distance relationships never work. Sometimes those 2 or 3 times we talked with each other, they lasted for about 2 hours. So allow the record to show that this did not break the record of talking over the phone with Johnny and myself. Let me clarify. That was 2 hours and 30 minutes. This was, however, 2 hours only. And so, and I say only.
That's kind of sad that your record for longest talking on the phone is with Johnny and not with the woman.
Yeah, so, I know. It truly shows tragic dependability upon Asian people, which I feel as a country... we should break away from. Now,
agreed.
You could say that she was very gung-ho. And why I say she was gung-ho is because, you know, she was into shotguns and rifles. And
so what year was this?
2016.
Okay. So is terrible at relationships, and long-distance relationships never work.
Yeah, they never work. Although, however, he can't pull himself out of the wishing to have long-distance relationships, even though they never work. He's just self-destructing himself.
Ah, I see.
It's pretty sad, actually.
So next, he'll just start dating a woman from England.
Just further east. Go around the world.
Yes.
And then finally, he'll come all the way back around the world. He'll finally date somebody in California.
Sounds familiar.
And then he'll be like, whoa, wait a minute. You're dating somebody local?
If there's one thing we learned from this story and from this story, it is that long-distance relationships do not work.
They do not work.
And relationships where you... hit the bumper of your girlfriend's dad's car. Those relationships do not work either.
They do not work.
It's true.
0 for 3.
Too many girlfriends.
Yep. Almost all of them are married now.
Wow. Wait. You have PTSD from your friend who got married. This man represents us in a way that none of us could possibly understand.